We are in life.
Good morning, everybody. And good morning in India, but I believe that it's not morning anymore, it's afternoon. And to all our viewers and continuing our international webinar, today's topic is setting SMART goals. So with further ado, I'll give it back to Mr. Anthony. Welcome back, sir. And he'll give us an introduction of our presenter today, Dr. Michi. You're welcome. So over to you, Mr. Anton.
Thank you very much, madam. Today, an important destination in our journey, actually. Good morning to all lovely people of Malawi and Zambia. As I told, today again, an important destination in our journey, goal setting SMART goals. If you imagine there is a ship in the ocean, the sailor, the captain of the ship don't know where to go. He don't know where is the which destination he has to reach. What will happen to that ship? Like the way. When we commonly speaking about goals, we may come across a lot of goals in our lifetime. During our childhood, we may have some goals. We may discuss about some goals. During our schooling periods, we may have some different type of different choices of goals. Now, after completing our graduation, being an important time of your starting your career. Now this is a time you have to seriously think of your goals actually. Just like that goals, if somebody is asking for my goal, immediately I will say I'm having a goal of achieving this, that, I have to reach that position. Right? That is not the goal simply means actually. Goals are such an important thing. Personal goals, professional goals, life goals, social goals, any number of goals available for us to reach actually. So today, my heartfelt welcome to an eminent professor, Dr. Michi. I'm very happy to introduce about her. I'm just sharing a small screen about our today's chief trainer. Yes. Today we are having an eminent professor, Dr. V.S. Michi Choni, and her academic qualification, MCom, MPhil, PhD. He is working for a very leading college. It is ranking 3 or 4 in the state, actually. The state called Tamil Nadu, Arulanandar College. It's a Jesuit college. She is working for the commerce department. And she is having 16 years of richest experiences, presented more than 30 papers in international and national seminars. And she attended more than 15 workshops. And she published 10 papers in the University Grand Commission approved journals. She is very passionate in doing presentations and all. And she co-authored a book, Fundamentals of Commerce, and she authored a book, A Study on the Passenger Preference of Railroad Transport. She served and is serving as a member of few committees of the college. She owned few international and national MOOC certificates in body language, professional ethic, human resource management, etc. Such a passionate trainer today we are having, and she used to give more importance to the values, actually. Values of life, values in career. if you are thinking in that dimension, today, this gentle trainer going to handle an important topic that too related with the values. Now, with this small introduction, I am handing over the session to respected Dr. Neji Choni Madam. Welcome to the session, ma'am. The session is yours.
Before getting into my presentation, I would like to record my gratitude to the officials of St. John the Baptist University, Malawi, and St. Eugene's University, Zambia. Moreover, for providing me this wonderful opportunity. Welcome all the viewers. I hope this is the sixth day of this webinar series. Today's theme is goal setting. How to set SMART goals. Now we will get into the presentation. Before getting into the presentation, I'd like to ask just a question. Have you ever thought about what you'd like to be doing in the next 5 years of time? Some may be saying yes and some may be no. Now, today, I call every one of you to think over it because we all know that goal setting is an outstanding plays an outstanding role in our life. What is this goal? It's a target or objective. Target towards all our efforts can be directed towards. This goal serves as an energizer or booster, and it serves as a stimulator also. It stimulates the person or people to put an extra effort on their goals. If you are setting goals, they make us to be focused and committed. They give something to work toward and something to hope for and something to dream about. And finally, it motivates us to accomplish our objectives. Always these goals help us to stay on track. Without goals or in the absence of the goals, we may move off in the wrong direction, wasting all our efforts or resources, money, time, and all other resources. Eventually, it gives meaning to your life and colorfulness to your life. So this is all about the introduction of goals and the importance of goals. Next, we will see the categories of life goals. Our life goals can be categorized into 7. And the first one is academic goals. And second one is career goals, monetary goals, ethical goals, creative goals, domestic goals, and physical goals. What is academic goals? If we are planning something towards enriching our knowledge or updating our qualifications they are coming under the category of academic goals. Next one is career goals. If we want to improve our level of job or career, or if we want to plan something on starting of a business or an enterprise, they are coming under the category of career goals. Then what is monetary goals? It is related with financial goals. If we want to earn something, they are coming under monetary goals. Then ethical goals. These goals are related with engaging ourselves in any service or charity activities or politics, or goals related with philanthropy. These are coming under ethical goals. Next one is creative goals. If you are setting goals creatively in order to progress in your life, not missionary, it is purely related with creativity. All those goals are coming under creative goals. Next one is domestic goals. This is all about personal life, that is domestic life, to be what I am going to be in the future, or related with marriage or in a relationship. Likewise, if we are setting goals like that, they are coming under domestic goals. Next one is physical goals. These goals are connected with physical activities. If you want to improve our skills in any sports or games, are related with our physique, that is becoming fit or losing weight. So if we want to, if we are setting goals related with these categories, they are coming under physical goals. These goals can be divided into two types, that is short-term goals and long-term goals. Short-term goals, we can achieve that within a short span of time. Long-term goals means it will take some more time, that is more than 1 year. If you want to construct a house, that will be coming under the category of long-term goals. If you want to buy a watch or something like that, will be coming under short-term goals. Then we'll go to the next slide. Dream versus goal. Many of us get confused with these two terms. They are different in meaning. We'll see what are the differences between this dream and goal. Dream is a fantasy and does not have any boundaries. It's a sequence or series of our emotions, ideas, sensations and the like. But goal is a more clear and vivid target we want to attain. The next difference is, it's a goal without legs. We used to get dreams at different stages of our sleep. But as far as goal is concerned, it is always accompanied with plans. Dreams does not have any plans. With the help of plans only, we can accomplish the goals. And here, next difference is, these dreams may be the deepest desires and anxieties of our life. It's a manifestations of unfulfilled desires or anxieties. Here, goal means it's an aim or objective or target that we want to achieve. These are all the differences between dream and goal. Here comes the seven steps of setting goals. Steps or process. First one is identifying the goals. Second one, setting objectives. Third one, listing the obstacles or hindrances. Next one is identifying people, listing the skills, developing a plan, and listing the benefits. While setting the goals, we must cross these 7 steps or process. Then only we can achieve the goals or accomplish the goals effectively. First step is identifying the goals. How we will identify the goals? Actually, goal setting is a process that starts with careful consideration of what you want to achieve. You should identify the goals you need to set. How you will be identifying the goals? Before identifying the goals, you should ask some questions to yourself. What do I want to offer my family, or to the society, or to the world? And how do I want to grow? These are all some questions we should ask to ourselves. Then you have to choose your values. What are the values you're having? How these values are helping me to identify the goals which I am going to set. Then you have to analyze your interests and skills. There is a close relationship between values, interests, and skills. You may be interested in several skills in the schools or in the college life. According to the skills and the interests, you can identify the goals. In what field or in what area I am having interest? In that area, I can fix my goal. Likewise, you can identify the goals. Or you can do some research. You can identify your dream job. And the research in the sense, you have to analyze who is involved in the same field that you like. Have to make a small study in that job, whether this job is fit for me. Can I survive? If I set a goal to get this job, can I survive in this job? You have to consider the positive skills and all the negativeness of that particular job. Then only you can identify your goals. If you are interested in games, you can set goals in that particular area. Next one is setting objectives. This is the second step of setting objectives. Your objectives must be narrow in scope. It should not be a general one or broader one. You have to set specific goals or objectives. Then only you can reach the target very easily. That objectives are associated with schedule and time frame. You have to schedule the objectives and time frame also you have to fix. Within this time, I have to finish this or accomplish this objective. Like that, you have to schedule your objectives and you have to set a time frame for that. Whether it is a short-term goal or whether it is a medium term, you have to set time for it. The examples include, I will work with a coach to practice my networking skills by the end of this month. This is a specific goal. When it comes to general goal, how you can fix this goal? I want to improve my networking skills. This is somewhat general goal. If you are narrowing it down or you're making that goal into specific one, you can frame like this. I will work with the coach to practice my networking skills by the end of this month. You have to approach a coach. So that is the specific objective here. I want to become an expert in networking skills is a general objective that is broader in sense. So when we are framing objectives or setting objectives, see to that it should be a specific one. Next, the third step is you have to find out the or list down the obstacles or hindrances or barriers. First one is fear. Fear of failure, fear of loss, fear of emptiness, fear of unknown fears, fear of success. So don't give space to these type of fears. If you're giving space to these type of fears, then you cannot accept the, you cannot accomplish the objectives very easily. So, consider that first you should avoid the fearness from you. Next one, taking big steps. When setting objectives, we have to travel in a track or path. We have to walk long distance. When we are walking or taking steps, we should not take big steps. We have to take smaller steps. Smaller and again, you can make it into very smaller steps. Day by day. Step by step, you can accomplish the objectives. For that, you have to frame little objectives or goals. If you are taking bigger steps, then in the future, you have to worry about that. That is a destructive behavior. We cannot survey then. It will stimulate us to stop trying if we are taking big steps. So think that we have to get to walk into the path by taking smaller steps. Then next obstacle is excuses. Often we say some excuses to ourselves. I'm not ready for that. It's not the right time to start. I'm not good enough. I am too old or young. People will laugh at me. Like that, we will be afraid of or saying excuses to ourselves. So we have to come out of these excuses. We must not say excuses like this. If you are saying these excuses, we cannot achieve the goals. Then some expectations. Expecting too much. Expectations must be there, but it should not be too much. Big expectations that we should not do. If you are having or developing too much expectations, finally we will be facing some disappointments. It will decrease our motivation also. So we should not give space to too much expectations. Here an example I can say, if you are starting the business with $5,000, and within 3 months if you want to recoup that amount, not that amount, if you are expecting to recoup some $15,000 or something like that, or $50,000 or something like that, that is too much expectation. We should not expect like that. Our expectation should be reasonable. Otherwise, as I already told, we may face disappointments in the path of our journey. Then distractions. This is also another obstacle we used to face. Don't give space to distractions. People are there to distract her. Don't give space to them. They'll create some demotivational activities among ourselves. They'll be the reason for losing hope in attaining the goals. And they'll be criticizing our initiations and all. So we should not get distracted with that people. The next one is lack of creativity. If you are having creativity, we can adjust any situations and accomplish our goal. If we lack the creativity, then definitely we won't be getting success in our path. If situations go wrong when you are setting objectives or in your journey, we have the creativity to adjust that. We should have some alternative methods to implement in our path. So we should be getting the goals very easily. The next one is lack of mentorship. Mentors are very essential for our life. We have to keep some mentors or well-wishers or advisors, teachers, or even friends near to us. If you are not having these mentors, definitely we may fail. Their ideas, their motivation, their stimulation, all are essential to get the success. So third step is obstacles. You have to list down all these obstacles. Not only listing the obstacles, we have to try for overcoming these obstacles or to tackle these obstacles from our path. Next step is, fourth step is identifying the people. We have to keep around the person you want to influence. Who can say yes and make your dreams come true? Or the people who are always there to help you in our path. They'll be giving ideas or some strategies for developing our or implementing our goals or achieving our goals. So always we should identify such people and we should be having that people around us, because achieving the goals is collective efforts of like-minded people. So you have to identify the people very correctly. Next one, listing of the skills. We have to list down all the skills we are having. What skills are needed for accomplishing our goals or setting our goals? For setting the goals itself, we need many skills. First, you have to plan and we have to monitor the things. How our efforts are going. Are they going in a right path? That we have to monitor. Without planning, we cannot set goals. Because without plans, we may fail in the efforts. So planning and monitoring skills must be there with us. Next one, focus. We should focus our attention in our goals. After setting goals, we have to focus our attention. Otherwise, we may bound to move off in the wrong direction. And all the entire efforts will be getting waste. So focus or attention is very essential. Then time management. Time management is very essential. If it is a short-term goal, we have to finish that particular or accomplish that particular goal within the time frame set by ourselves. Or whether it is a long-term goal, it may take more than 1 year. For that also, time management is very essential. Then flexibility. You must have the skill of flexibility. As I have already told, if the things are going in a wrong direction or not going in a way we are expecting, we have the mindset to flexible our ideas. If one idea is not working, we have to implement another idea. We have the mindset to change the things or change the ideas. Next skill is motivation. Motivation is a wide area. In the coming slides, we'll be seeing the motivation, what kind of motivation will be needed to accomplish the objectives. Next one is blame your effort and not your ability. We should not blame our effort, but our abilities we can blame. Next one is, you should not be a pessimistic one, you should be an optimistic one. You should see the positive things. You should not spend time in the negative things. It will be demotivating you. So optimism is an essential skill which you should develop in yourself. Next one is self-control. You should practice the skill of self-control. So this is the fifth process of setting goals, listing the skills. Next one is important process in goal setting, developing a plan. It's a lifeblood of goal setting. You have to develop the plan. After the completion of the above or previous process, now you have to develop the plan. Numerous research projects true that when people make a concrete plan, then are more than twice as likely to reach their goals. So without a plan, we cannot succeed in our targets, or we cannot accomplish the objectives. We should put a tangible and a concrete plan, which are needed for achieving the goals. Then keep your plan close by. So you can see how each action step is working, and make improvements to the plan as you go. You have to monitor the plans. If somewhere you are failing, you can make improvements there. If any weakness there, you can work towards transforming that weaknesses into strengths. The next one is, goal without a plan is just a wish. So always plan must be there to achieve our goals. Otherwise, it will remain only as a wish or dream. By writing out the individual steps, you then crossing each one of you as you complete. When planning, when you are drafting an action plan, you have to write by individual steps. What I am going to do this year. Next year, what I am going to do. And the next day, day-wise also you can develop your plans, or week-wise. So likewise, step by step, you have to implement your plans. Next step is listing the benefits. What benefits you are going to attain from accomplishing these objectives or goals, that you have to list down. Then only these benefits, or listing these benefits, will be helping you or motivating you or encouraging you to do the further works. So what benefits you'll be getting out of the goals or accomplishing the objectives or goals? Improves your self-image. Automatically, after accomplishing the objectives or goals, it will improve your self-image. Then make you aware of your strengths, which can be used to overcome obstacles and provide solutions to the problems. You should be aware of all your strengths, which can be used to overcome obstacles. If you have the strengths, enough strengths, then only you can overcome the obstacles. In the second step, in the third step, you have list down all the obstacles or hindrances now. So how you will overcome from these obstacles or hindrances? You have to make use of your strengths. Then only it will be providing solutions to the problems. Next one, makes you aware of your weaknesses so that you can begin to improve them and make them into your strengths. Not only the strengths, but the weaknesses also you have to be aware of. Then only you can make that or transform that weaknesses into strengths. Next one, it gives a sense of past victories and provides a stimulus for present successes. When listing the benefits, you have to consider the past victories also, because that past victories provides you a stimulus for present successes. With the help of that past victories, we can get self-motivation, a confidence or courage to solve the present problems. And then it will be helping you to get the present success. Next one, it gives you a track to run on, so you can see where you have to go. You should walk on the track as I have already told, without goals, we cannot walk on the track. There is a certain path there. Through that path only we have to walk or run. Then only we can know where we have to go. So after traveling in that track or path, you'll be getting so many benefits. So that benefits also you have to list down. And the other benefit is making you responsible for your own life. If you are achieving the goals or accomplishing the goals, then you'll be responsible for your own life. You'll be an independent person or independent personality, well-known personality. You become a well-known personality. So for these purposes, you have to list all the benefits previously. Then only you can take your steps very cautiously. Next one, difference between goal setters and non-goal setters. From all these previous slides, we have seen the importance of goal setting. So now we are going to see what are the differences these goal setters and non-goal setters are experiencing. First one, we'll take the goal setter scenario and a non-goal setter scenario. For this goal setter, you can give the name John. He wants to take a vacation or a trip. For that, he is planning. He then writes down 20 ways he can cut back on spending to make this happen. He is taking all his efforts to save money. He is planning for that. For his vision, in order to accomplish his goal is taking a vacation. For taking that vacation or trip, he wants, let us assume that $2,000 he wants. So for achieving that, or for making that money, $2,000, he has to save some money. 4 months are there. Let us assume that 4 months are there. From today, 4 months are there. He has to save at least $500 each month. So if he is saving $500 each month, he can collect that money. That is $2,000. For that, he is planning. He's putting all his efforts to save that money. Now we'll come to the non-goal setter scenario. We'll call this person as Michael. He has great ideas and big dreams like John, but doesn't feel he has the time to set an exact plan for how to achieve them. He also wants to take that vacation. He also wants to save money, but he's not planning anything. He's not putting his efforts into practice in order to achieve his goal. So thinking, and he's going on thinking, but he's not making money or saving money or not at all planning to save that money. So what will be happening at the end of the fourth month? Who will take the journey or who will take the vacation? This John will be taking the vacation and he will be losing. This Michael will be losing. That is the difference between goal setter and non-goal setter. So try to be the goal setter and not like the non-goal setter, Michael. How do you set a goal? Your goal cannot contradict any of your other goals. For example, you are earning $50,000 in a year per month, per annum. Per annum, you are earning $50,000. But within 3 years of time, you want to buy a house worth ₹2 lakhs. So it has some contradiction in your goals. Only you are earning 50,000 per year. Within 3 years, you want to get it for 2 lakhs or something more like that. So your goal should not get contradiction with other goals. Set your goals and make them happen. Some may set their goals and keep silent for the next period. Next period means the coming days they'll be keeping silence without taking any efforts. It should not be like that. After setting your goals, you should try or put all your efforts to make it success or in order to achieve the goals and make positive goals and not negative goals. I mean, if you want to quit that the present job and want to join a new job, don't frame the negative goal of I want to quit the job. But instead of that, you can make positive goals, such as I want to join in a good job. Next one is decide. Think of something you want to do or work towards. After setting the goals, don't keep silence. Think of something you want to do or work towards. What efforts I can take to achieve that goals? Whom I have to meet? What resources I have to gather? Likewise, you can decide. Write it down. After deciding the things, you can write it down carefully. According to that, you can act in the future. And tell your goals with someone. Telling someone we know about our goals also seem to increase the likelihood that we will stick on them. If you are sharing our goals with someone, definitely we will try to implement that goal or achieve that goal. If you are not saying with anyone, sometimes it will be a demotivation. It will create some demotivation within us. So in order to get motivated, we can convey our goals with someone. Next one, break your goal down. This is especially important for big goals. If you have to set big goals, big goals, you can break it down into small goals. You can divide and delegate the works. Then only it will be easier to accomplish the objectives. Because if it is a big goal, you'll get demotivated. So plan to do bit by bit or make it into smaller goals and you can do it. Then plan your first step. After dividing these goals, you can get into the planning of your goals. Then you can move on working and finally you can celebrate the achievement of your goals. then how your goal should be. It should be SMART goal. Today's topic itself is setting up SMART goals. What do you mean by SMART? Each letter carries each character or feature. First one is specific. You should frame specific goals. Clear and well-defined goals must be there. You have to frame specific and non-general goals. If it is general goals, then achievement become very slower and it has some difficulties to achieve. So you have to make it into specific goal. Narrow down your goals. Vague and generalized goals are unhelpful. Clear cut or specific goals must be there. Then only it will help us to work on it. Then goals must show you the way. If you are setting goals, it must show you the way. It should not keep you offside. Then, before setting these specific goals, you should ask few questions, WH questions. First one is, what do I want to accomplish? Then, why I want to accomplish this goal? What are the reasons or purposes for which I am going to accomplish this goal? And who are all involved in accomplishing this goal? And where? Identify a location for that. From where I am going to achieve this goal? Do we need any space for that or location for that? That we have to decide. Then, what are the requirements and constraints involved? What requirements are needed to accomplish that goals? Many requirements are there to accomplish our goals. According to the goals, these requirements may vary. And the constraints also. So, well in advance, you have to decide about these. Or you have to get answers for these five questions. Then only on these base, you can frame specific goals. Then M stands for measurable goals. It must be a measurable one. Make sure your goal is measurable. Include precise amounts or dates. Some dates or time should be there in your goal. That is called measurable goals. For example, within the next 3 months of time, I'll be publishing a book. So we are mentioning the date there. That is coming under this goal, measurable goal. If you are setting some amounts or dates, within this month I have to earn this much amount. So that is coming under these goals. Then keep you on track. Measurable goals keep you on track. You should walk on the path you have planned or determined already or well in advance. Then target dates you have to fix. Within that dates, you have to finish off your works. Then experience the sense of achievement. If you are setting measurable goals, you will be experiencing the sense of achievement. Otherwise, it will be a blind goal. Without fixing dates or amounts, that goals will coming under the blind goals. Otherwise, if you are fixing these dates or measurable things in your goals, the sense of achievement or satisfaction will be will be gaining from that goals, measurable goals. It involves three questions: how many, how much, and how long. How long I will take to finish this particular objective or goal? How much amount I am going to earn from this goal? Or how much days I want to complete this or accomplish this goal? Likewise, you have to fix your goals. A stands for achievable goals. You have to set achievable goals or attainable goals. Have to see that whether the sufficient resources are at your disposal in order to achieve the goals. If you are lacking resources, you're not able to achieve the goals in time. So when fixing the goals itself, you should see to that whether these goals are achievable by me or attainable by me. You have to adjust the workload requirements with that of the sufficient resources. Whether these resources are enough for moving my goals, moving my efforts. Likewise, you have to fix your goals. Then it must be that the goal must have the feature of altering. If any particular goal set by you is not according to the requirements, then set your goals. It should not be a fixed one. It should be a variable one. If you find any difficulty in doing or achieving that particular goal, you should have to alter your goal. According to that, you have to fix your goals. And it should not be a too easiest one to attain. While fixing the goals, even if it is attainable goal, you should not fix too easiest one, because we don't find any interest in that. It will be a motivating thing. It will make us idle. So it should be a challenging one and interesting one. And a reasonable one, not too easiest and not too difficult one or hardest one. For example, I'll hire an editor to review my writing before it is published. It's an achievable goal. In order to accomplish the objective of writing or publishing a book, I want to hire an editor to review my writing. Then only I can publish my article or book. So it's an achievable one. I can get an editor to review my writings. He'll be giving the feedbacks after editing the book. So it is an achievable one only. If I like to hire 10 editors or 15 editors to review my writing, it will be a easiest one. In this example, I am saying, likewise, you have to set your goals. It should be an achievable one or attainable one. Next one, relevant goals. R stands for relevant goals. Goals that support or in alignment with other goals. When setting goals, your one goal should support the other goals. Already we have seen an example. When you want to buy a home or buy a house, you have to earn more. You need 5 lakh rupees or $5 lakh to get a home. So supporting goals must be there. So you have to yearn for that. So it got some alignment with other goals. If you are earning that much money, you can achieve that goals. If you are not earning that much amount, it is irrelevant. If you are earning to get that house, that is relevant goal. Accordingly, you have to set your goals. Goals will be consistent with the competencies and behaviors of ourselves. Because while fixing goals, it should not be inconsistent with our competencies, skills, or behaviors. For this, we have to list down our competencies or behaviors or skills. If I am setting goals, if I am setting goal to write a book or publish a book, what competencies or skills I am having to accomplish that goals? If I am competent to write that book or publish that book, then only I can set goals to achieve it. So it should be inconsistent with the competencies or skills we are possessing. Then scattered and inconsistent goals will fritter your time and life. This has connection with the previous point. Inconsistent goals, scattered goals, if it is not relevant, that will be wasting your time and all the efforts of your life. So always go for relevant goals. In this example, I want a job which gives me more time with my family. I want a job. At the same time, I want to spend more time with my family. So this is relevant goals. Likewise, you have to fix your or set your goals. If you're not able to spend time with your family, that is a irrelevant goal. You want a job which gives me more time with the family. This is somewhat relevant. So go for setting relevant goals. And the last letter is time, T. It stands for time-bound goals. You have to set a deadline, a time for your goals. Otherwise, it will be a stretchable one. You cannot accomplish the goals within the time frame. Set deadline for that. Within this time limit, within 1 year, I have to write this book and publish. Within 8 months, I have to complete this work and get edited with an editor. That is time-bound goal. Time frame or target date must be there. It will create a sense of urgency in our efforts. If you are not having this sense, we cannot move forward. We will be getting delayed in our work because there the motivation fails. If you are fixing a time frame, then only we can get self-motivation. Automatically, we will finish the work within that time. Example, as I have already told, I will publish a book per year for 5 years by having each one ready in 9 months. So I am planning to publish books for 5 years, and for each 9 months, I am going to complete that book, finish that book. So I am setting a time bound here in this goal. So please set a time frame for your goal. Whatever goal you can fix, you have to set a time frame or deadline for that. Another example, I will finish my project within the next 3 months. So here also the time frame is coming. So within next 3 months, I will be finishing my thesis or my project. So without time frame or deadline, you cannot get into the goals. If you are getting into that goals, it will be a waste of efforts. Next one is motivation. First, we have seen 7 steps for setting the goals. And we have seen the we have seen SMART goals, how we have to set the SMART goals. Now we are going to see motivation. How much motivation is necessary in order to accomplish our objectives? It's a main part. Without motivation, we cannot do anything. Setting goals and all are mere waste of time, waste of energy, and waste of money. So here also some steps are coming in order to motivate ourselves. First, you have to write our story. Write your story in a paragraph, in a 1 or 2 paragraph, you can write your story. What I am going to do in the next year, what I am going to accomplish out of my goals, that you have to write. Then visualize into the future. Here you can close your eyes and visualize the future. What things are going to happen in your future, that you have to visualize. Then have to go backwards also. Visualize backwards. Past years, where am I? In the coming years, where I want to be. So with the help of this visualization, backward visualization, we can move to the future very successfully. Then dream big. Have to dream bigger. Then only we can cross the small obstacles we are facing each and every day. If you are dreaming big, you'll be having the focus on that only. You won't give importance to the small hindrances or obstacles coming on the way. Then educate yourself. How you can educate yourself? You can read more motivational books or motivational quotes. You can read something. You can talk or speak something. Through these experiences, you can educate yourself. It will be very helpful to accomplish your objectives. Then always find a role model. This is very essential for our achievement. One role model you should keep in your mind. You can follow him. You can read about him. Out of this, you can get big experience, and in that way you can act in order to achieve your goals. Then get organized. Get organized in the sense you can keep your home or office in a neat and tidy manner. Automatically, this will motivate yourself. If your mind is free, you can do your work very well. You can move forward easily. So always get organized. And you can keep positive affirmation cards around. What is positive affirmation? Positive words or positive phrases or positive affirmation sentences you can keep around you. You can keep positive affirmation words in your mirror, in your purse, wallet, in your car, or wherever you see, you can keep your positive affirmation cards or phrases. What is positive affirmation word? Positive affirmation words like bright, smart, honest, like we see, you can keep. Positive affirmation phrase means keep going, do smartly, like we see, you can keep. Positive affirmation sentences means I can do it smartly. I'm a bright person. I can finish it with very effectively or very quickly. I can finish this work. I'm a positive person, positive minded person. Likewise, you can keep positive affirmation words, phrases or sentences around. So whenever you see or happen to see that words or phrases or sentences, automatically you'll be getting energy to accomplish your goals. Next one, place motivators around you. You should travel with motivators. You should not give space to demotivators. If you are keeping motivators around you, you'll be getting energy or stimulation automatically. You'll be doing your work very fastly and positively you can finish that work. You will not give any space for demotivation. Then you can read motivational quotes. Daily you can read motivational quotes. Many motivational quotes are there in the internet. Or through books also you can read many motivational quotes. This also gives some inspiration to you. Next one, you can spend time with children. If we spend or play time with children, automatically we will be in a stress-free life. Stress or any other worries will fly away. So try to spend some time with children. Then you can read success stories. You can read success stories of the successful or eminent personalities you come across. It will also give you some motivation. You'll be on the track. Reading these stories, success stories of well-known personalities, keep you on track. Without any hindrances, you can walk through or run through. Then have healthy diet. If you are having health, maintaining healthy body, then only we can accomplish our objectives or goals. So we have to consider this point. We have to give importance, more importance to this particular point. Have to eat well. Assure that that diet consists of nutrients or minerals or vitamins needed for your body. Then you should get enough sleep. Then only you'll be getting refreshing life or move. No setbacks. You should not get demotivated. You should not withdraw your goals already set for implementing it. So these are all the points connected with motivation. If you are following these points, definitely it will be taking you to the destination, a right destination. Some more tips for goal setting. Apart from these motivation, some other qualities are needed or tips are needed in order to achieve our goals. First, use goals throughout the life. Don't set goals for a particular time. I mean, throughout your life, goals should be there. Big or small, one or another, some goals should be there. Then only we'll be getting some interest in your life. We'll get some inspiration in our life. Then brainstorm. You have to sit and think. Think about what is my desire? What is my dream? What I am going to achieve? What ideas I can get in order to accomplish that objectives? Sometimes some ideas may pop into your head. So in a silent place, you can sit and think about the ideas. Some new ideas, some creativeness may come into your mind. Then as a next step, you should write down the goal. In the previous step, in the brainstorm session, you might be getting some ideas. Then after that, you can write down in a paper. Because if you are floating the ideas in the head itself, during the course of time, you will be forgetting about that ideas. So before achieving that goal, you have to write down in a paper. Next one is, don't overdo it. Complication should not be there in the goal setting. Complicated goals you should not fix. You have to set clear and vivid goals. Then only you cannot get into the complication. You'll be doing all the works very clearly. Then measure your progress. After setting the goals, now and then you have to measure your progress. So as I have already told, if I want to write a book or publish a book, we will be dividing the goals. Today, how many pages I am going to write? Tomorrow, how many pages I am going to finish? So, if you are setting to write 50 or 60 pages today, you have to measure at the end of today whether I have completed today's target. So likewise, you have to measure your progress. Likewise, tomorrow. Tomorrow, you have planned to complete or finish some 100 pages. So at the end of tomorrow's evening or night, you have to measure your progress. how much I have completed, how many pages I have completed. Like you say, have to measure. Then reward yourself. Now and then you have to reward yourself. Whether if you have completed the work of today, you can go for dinner or you can celebrate that. Then only it will be a self, it will be giving some self-satisfaction and a sense of completion or some satisfaction in your mind. If you are rewarding yourself, if you are not rewarding yourself, you won't get the motivation or stimulation to get into the next part of that goal. Then identify the benefits. This I have already explained in the previous, one of the previous slides. You have to list down or identify the benefits. Keeping these benefits as a base, we have to identify or set the goals. Some more tips for you. Assertive behavior. What is assertive behavior? Assertive behavior means respecting others, following some honesty in our behavior, in our actions, or in our words. You should not be an aggressive, should not possess the behavior of aggressiveness. So aggressiveness is the opposite of this assertive behavior. Assertiveness means you have to accept others. You have to give respect to others. You should have some honest policy. Aggressiveness, those who are having aggressive or those who are possessing aggressive behavior may be developing the character or quality of anger, arrogance, or sarcasm and the like. So you should not be like that. If you are practicing assertive behavior, definitely it will be a giving some fruitfulness to your goals. You can get involved in others very easily. You cannot restrict from others. So those who are having aggressive behavior cannot get involved with other people. So their development is curtailed through their behaviors. Next one is accepting feedbacks. Always these feedbacks help to correct ourselves. So be ready to invite the feedbacks of others. Others in the sense your mentor, your well-wishers, or your friends. Now and then you can get feedbacks from themselves. How you are moving? Are you moving in the right direction? Or any correction is needed in your routine work? Like that you can, for this purpose, you can accept feedbacks from others. Avoid toxic people. Toxic people in the sense, they'll be giving demotivation, negative people, having negative thoughts. If you're keeping aside these type of people, we cannot grow in your career. Definitely it will be creating or diminishing our motivation. So try to avoid toxic people from you. Use deadlines. In the time board or setting a time frame objective itself, we have seen we have to set deadlines for our objectives. So if we are setting goals, some dates or target must be there. Within that time limit, we have to finish our work. Use a start date also, not only deadlines or time frame. For start, after setting the goals, you have to fix a date for starting that. Starting your efforts in order to achieve that goals. So use a start date also. Then develop the persistence. Without persistence or hard work, we cannot achieve our goals. So always try to help develop the quality of persistence. Then balance your efforts. Efforts in the sense, you'll be putting all your efforts in order to accomplish a objective or goal. So make your efforts in a balancing manner. Say, for example, four goals you are having or setting four goals. For each and every goal, you have to put same amount of efforts, same amount of time, same amount of money or other efforts. Then only you can achieve your goals effectively and efficiently. Then you have to prioritize the goals. Likewise, four objectives you are having. From these four objectives or goals, you have to prioritize that. For which goal I have to give first priority? For example, related with health, we are keeping a goal. Related with family, we are keeping a goal. And related with your skills, you are keeping a goal. So for what goal you'll be giving first priority? Definitely you'll be giving priority to the health goals, health related goals. If you are healthy only, we can move in the right path. So first we have to prioritize the health goals. In this example, you have to give second priority to the family. Then to the next goals. Likewise, according to your mindset, you have to give priority to your goals. Then only you can achieve your goals in an effective manner. Then make your goals challenging. Some challenge must be there. Then only you'll be creating self-interest to do your or finish your, accomplish your goal. The sense of challenge must be there. So these are all the tips needed for achieving the goals. Now I want to give you some examples of great personalities and their books. First one is Brian Tracy. He's an American. He's a motivational speaker. He has authored more than 60 books and produced more than 500 audio and video learning programs on sales, management, business success, and personal development. Another book is The Psychology of Achievement. If you get the chance to read these books, you can read these books. Automatically, you will be developing your sense of motivation and encouragement. This personality's goal is to help you achieve your personal and business goals faster and easier than you ever imagined. If you get a chance to read the biography of this Brian Tracy, you can read. The next person is Tony Robbins. He's also a public speaker and an author and a philanthropist. He's an American life coach, that is motivational trainer. He's famous for his self-help books such as Unlimited Power, Awaken the Giant Within, Unleash the Power Within. And he is famous for his seminars on the following topics: health and energy, breaking conventional fears, accumulating more wealth, optimum utilization of the available resources, maintaining and enhancing relationships and communication. His biography also you can read. When you are reading the books of these persons or biography or autobiographies of these persons or personalities, you can self-motivate yourself. You'll be getting inspiration to work forward. Next one, Catherine Eunice Schwarzenegger. She is the elder daughter of a journalist, Maria Shriver, and actor cum politician Arnold Schwarzenegger. You may be knowing this personality. One of her books is Rock What You Have Got: Secrets to Loving Your Inner and Outer Beauty from Someone Who's Been There and Back. Another book is I Just Graduated, Now What? These books will be helping you much. So please, students, please go through these books and get motivated out of this. Some books names I give you. This book name is Creating Your Best Life, written by Carolyn Miller. After conducting some research, she weaves rich tales of goal accomplishment and happiness in with goal setting exercises. This book consists of several exercises connected with goal setting. So you can read this book also. This book creates an interactive and encouraging way to view life goals and achievement. When you read this book, automatically you'll be improving the career by achieving or accomplishing the goals in an effective manner. Another book is Your Best Year Ever, written by Michael Hyatt. He also, after conducting many researches, he has written many books. Whether it's a personal or relationship or business or financial goal, you have to set up ways in order to avoid stucking into the goals. When you read these books, you'll be getting ideas to overcome the ways to unstuck the goals in your life. And these books will be helping people to overcome their day-to-day struggles and to reach their potential very easily. This book helps to envision the reader's best year ever. Book name is Your Best Year Ever. Next book is The Book of Mistakes. Here, Mr. Skip Pritchard gave 9 mistakes that highly successful people don't make. If you get into the book, you can read all those 9 mistakes and you can rectify yourself. Next book name is 9 Things Successful People Do Differently, written by Heidi Grant Halvorsen. In this book, he has given 9 things successful people do differently. First one, get specific. Second one is, seize the moment to act on your goals. Next one is, know exactly where the goal line is. Next one, be a realistic optimist. Next one, focus on getting better rather than being good. Have the willingness to commit to long-term goals. Next one, build your willpower. Next is, don't tempt fate. The last one is, focus on what you will do. So in order to develop these 9 characters or qualities among you, you can read out this book. Finally, a take home message from me. Success doesn't happen by accident. People who are high achievers have similar habits, and one of them is effective goal setting. So, read it again and again. Success doesn't happen by accident. For this, you have to work more and more by implementing some tips and some qualities needed for achieving your goal. Learn to set goals that inspire you and make things happen. You are never too old to set another goal or to dream a new dream. With Tony Robbins' quote, I want to end up the session. Your past does not equal your future. Thank you, students.
Thank you very much, Dr. Miji, for this wonderful presentation. I hope that all our viewers have really grasped something and taken so much knowledge from today's seminar. I'm really, really grateful, and I believe that everyone participating is also grateful. Thank you very much.
So, my dear students, all the very best. If you have any doubts, you can ask.
So to anyone who has any questions on which they would like to ask her, she's very much willing to answer all your questions or all your doubts with what she has discussed with you today. So please do ask your questions and she'll be very much ready to answer you.
You can clarify. Okay, right. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you very much, Dr. Michi, for today and for giving us your time.
Okay, we'll meet you.
Grateful.
In another session. Thank you.